tropical forests are burning in Guatemala. Historic droughts and illegal land clearing in the northern Petén region now threatens Mirador National Park. Many of the park's endangered wildlife species are on the brink of extinction. The most significant archaeological sites in Mesoamerica exist in El Mirador, many being meticulously restored, while others remain in states of arrested decay. This important work has been nearly curtailed as rangers battle the purposely set fires, while also under the threat of a global pandemic. The Mirador National Park Genesis Program is led by Francisco Asturias. Francisco is director of FundaEco, Global Conservation's NGO partner in Guatemala, where he supervises the protection of over 660,000 acres of endangered forests and archaeological treasures.
There are not natural fires in Petén. Fires in Petén, 99% are made by humans. Two reasons, for cattle, and usually it's narco ganaderos, we call them. And also poor people, communities, invaders, and the national parks also fire the forest, so the next year they will plant their corn to survive.
What once was the cradle of a sprawling Maya civilization is now the largest intact forest and wildlife habitat remaining in Central America. Hidden in the depths of this verdant forest are some of the largest pyramids on Earth. Connecting them just beneath tree roots winding through thick black soil are hundreds of miles of ancient plastered roads that once glowed limestone white, connecting an area larger than Yellowstone National Park. Mirador National Park contains large populations of jaguar, alongside puma, tapir, and other critical species. Francisco has been a longtime conservationist who served as director of Mirador National Park from 2014 to 2017. He has been working with local communities for nearly 40 years. In 2016, he inspired a film about jaguar conservation. Francisco Asturias is a born leader who has made a difference everywhere he has worked in Guatemala. Senate Bill S-3131, now in the U.S. Congress, has the potential to fund $150 million over 10 years to support the conservation and sustainable development of Mirador National Park. This funding has the potential to generate thousands of new jobs and income for one of the world's poorest countries, while increasing protections for the archaeological sites of Petén.
What we need here a lot is the resources. We've been working here for many, many years, and we know what to do. What we don't have is the resources. So if this law goes through, we will have more rangers. We can hire rangers from Carmelita and Huachactu communities, and there will be a lot of patrols, so we can have control of the area. So definitely that law needs to be passed, because there is no other way, there is no other light that we can see that will help us to get all the money that we need to do our work in here.
FundaEco and the Mirador Park Rangers are working together to stop wildlife poaching, looting of archaeological sites, illegal logging, and land clearing for cattle ranching by narco traffickers. With support from Global Conservation and the Global Park Defense System, they are slowing down the destruction of the park by making arrests and fighting fires. These rangers are a combined team of government police and military, NGO-trained rangers, and community eco-guards using the smart patrol system. Global Conservation is seeking UNESCO World Heritage designation for the Mirador Basin and pursuing land acquisition strategies to expand the park boundaries.
Sí, por supuesto que hay que fiscalizar y también hay que crear leyes, pero también incentivar a todos los grupos sociales. Hay que apoyar a las comunidades que están allá, nos preocupa bastante eso, para que se desarrolle esa área. Y miren, hay un potencial increíble. Estamos hablando de que al día de hoy se van descubriendo aproximadamente 640, 670 ciudades, y solo una de esas ciudades posee aproximadamente 10,000 sitios ahí arqueológicos. Hay nuevas tecnologías, hay nuevas ideas, hay desarrollo. Entonces hay que revisar esas leyes y hay que crear nuevos reglamentos también para el desarrollo de esa área.
We work with governors of the province, we work with the mayors of the surrounding communities, we're working with the villagers and the townspeople that live around the park to help them either work in the tourism area, work in conservation, as park protectors, as eco guards, part-time staff, along with the rangers.
Y le hago un llamado a la gente que ve este video. Como guatemalteco que soy, el único interés emotivo del Dr. Richard Hans es la investigación multidisciplinaria y protección de nuestro patrimonio natural y cultural. Y les confirmo que el Dr. Richard Hans está haciendo un excelente trabajo, un gran descubrimiento con todo su equipo, arqueólogos, todos, ¿no? Pues haciendo un excelente trabajo. Eso es algo de que se le agradece, ¿no? Pues a ellos por realizar ese trabajo, ese descubrimiento que hacen ellos acá en nuestro país de Guatemala.
Muy buenas tardes, hoy siendo el día domingo 13 de septiembre del 2020, nos encontramos aquí reunidos.
Queremos llegarle a hacer este mensaje al Dr. Richard con gente de las comunidades de acá de San Andrés y decirle que nosotros de todas las comunidades lo apoyamos. ¡Lo apoyamos!
¡Lo apoyamos, Dr. Hansen!
What happened to the ancient Maya civilization that once ruled these forests? 2,000 years ago, this civilization collapsed in the wake of ecological disaster. The swamps that supported their farms with nutrient-rich mud were killed by clay runoff caused by the wholesale deforestation of the surrounding area. The Maya had been destroying the forest for firewood to make limestone plaster, to decorate their plazas and pyramids, an extravagance that eventually led to their own demise. We aim to preserve El Mirador's history, but not to repeat it, instead conserving forests and wetlands in perpetuity. Your support is critical to the success of Francisco Asturias and his rangers as they protect endangered wildlife, the last tropical forests in Central America, and the irreplaceable remnants of the great Maya civilization. Please visit our website to show your support and get involved today.